The most spectacular electrical phenomenon witnessed on planet Earth is lightning, a source of both fascination and fear for human beings for millennia. One might assume that in the 21st century, scientists' understanding of lightning should be so comprehensive, little room remains for mystery. However, as with many phenomena in nature, science discovery continues to reveal that lightning is not really as well understood as one might think. In fact, a commonality exists in the most surprising discoveries with respect to Earth lightning. Most significantly, from the electric universe perspective, a growing body of scientific literature affirms the significant role of the electrical circuitry between the Earth and the Sun on terrestrial lightning. Just last year, the European Geosciences Union published a remarkable paper entitled "Solar Cycle Signatures in Lightning Activity." The investigators studied global data from the Worldwide Lightning Location Network, and they documented correlations between sunspot activity and yearly lightning rates in Eastern Africa, a portion of South America which overlaps with the so-called South Atlantic Anomaly, the Indian Ocean, and the west coast of Australia. Also significantly, as the authors note in the paper's abstract, the findings of the present study do not support previous works indicating that cosmic ray intensity is in phase with the global occurrence of lightning. And unsurprisingly, the authors note of these findings, the exact mechanism leading to the link between lightning and solar activity is unknown. Along these lines, scientists were also recently surprised to discover high-energy electrons in the inner Van Allen radiation belt, which were consistently linked to geomagnetic storms, typically resulting from solar outbursts. The co-author of a paper published in Nature Communications describes the findings as follows. "We discovered that a combination of weather on Earth and weather in space produces the unique electron signatures we observed in our study. The solar activity disturbs Earth's radiation belts and populates the inner belt with very high energy electrons. Then the lightning interacts with these electrons and creates the rapid bursts that we observed. These results provide a nice reminder of the interconnected nature of Earth and space." Of course, the interconnectedness of the Earth and the Sun, and indeed of every celestial object with the larger universe, is at the core of the electric universe and electric sun theory. The EU has always proposed that Birkeland currents which flow from the Sun and touch down at our planet's poles drive our planet's aurorae, jet streams, and intense atmospheric and upper atmospheric phenomena, including lightning. The discovery of correlation between solar activity and lightning is thus a highly positive finding for EU theory. The most powerful type of so-called lightning on our planet is that which sometimes occurs above powerful thunderstorms, occasionally stretching to the upper reaches of the ionosphere. These stupendous electrical discharges go by names such as sprites, elves, and blue jets. Although the existence of these upper atmospheric electrical discharges was confirmed photographically in the late 1980s, for decades, highly credible eyewitnesses, including amateur astronomers and airline pilots, had shared anecdotal accounts of the phenomenon. However, as early as the 1920s, the Scottish physicist C.T.R. Wilson predicted the existence of brief flashes of light above powerful thunderstorms. As with many Earth and space mysteries, so-called above-clouds lightning only grows more enigmatic for mainstream science with each new discovery. In October of 2019, a pilot named Chris Holmes was flying over 30,000 feet above the Gulf of Mexico when he noticed multiple forms of powerful discharges coming from a thunderhead. "The huge snaking feature on your screen is a jet so enormous, it reaches all the way to the ionosphere." In this video clip, we see the above cloud perspective from which the jet emerged. This exceedingly rare footage allowed scientists to gain unprecedented insights into the mysterious phenomenon. Investigator Oscar Vanderveld of the Lightning Research Group split the video footage into individual frames and described the observed sequence of footage for the website spaceweather.com. He states, "First, relatively cool blue filaments spring up. These are streamers akin to St. Elmo's fire. Next, after the jet reaches its maximum height, another feature crawls more slowly out of the cloud top, a white-hot lightning leader." The Space Weather article notes why this is a surprise for conventional meteorology. For years, some researchers thought that gigantic jets could reach such extreme heights only if their streamers got a boost from the lightning leader. Holmes's video shows just the opposite. The gigantic jet reaches the ionosphere before the lightning leader even leaves the cloud. Oscar Vanderbilt concludes on the images. This suggests that there may be a much more powerful electric configuration inside the thunderstorm than was previously thought, perhaps as much as 200 million volts. To understand the significance of these findings for the electric universe theory, let us consider further some of the groundbreaking research into the nature of lightning on Earth. In 2001, Professor Edgar Baring of the University of Houston flew a high-altitude balloon above a thunderstorm. To his complete surprise, he found that when lightning strikes occurred both above and below the clouds, the electrical charge was already present and did not take time to build up between lightning strikes. This contradicts the standard notion that lightning is the generator of the clear air electric field, measured at about 100 volts per meter between the Earth and a clear sky. In standard theory, lightning's generation of power requires water droplets to separate charge in clouds, a process that remains mysterious and unverified. The electric universe theory, however, sees lightning and the cloud activity as a, quote, load that is driven by electric currents from the sun. In other words, it is the electrical circuitry between the sun and the Earth that drives all lightning. Returning to the giant jet observed in 2019, simply put, the reason the observed phenomenon is so surprising is because the evidence shows that the electrical charge that created the jet was already sitting at the cloud tops, a fact that is not surprising at all from the electric universe perspective. For over 20 years, I was able to discuss these issues with the late physicist Wal Thornhill, the chief proponent of the electric universe theory. He described the physics of terrestrial above clouds lightning as follows. The highest clouds essentially act like one plate of a capacitor, which responds to the buildup of charge in the ionosphere above, which is where the above clouds lightning terminates. The gigantic jets and other forms of above clouds electrical discharge are electrical breakdown channels in the Earth's, quote, leaky atmospheric capacitor. The discharge channel of Birkeland filaments narrows and forms the bright jets as it reaches into the more dense lower atmosphere. If electric currents from the sun are the ultimate drivers of lightning on planet Earth, what do we observe about the influence of the sun on the atmospheric and upper atmospheric activity on other planets? On Earth, we benefit from having clouds to distribute lightning. However, on the planet Mars, for instance, which has a very tenuous atmosphere, only about 0.5% as dense as Earth's, as well as a very weak magnetic field, solar storms may have legitimately shocking effects. Evidence for this is found in the dramatic dust plumes seen jetting hundreds of kilometers above the Martian surface, which have puzzled scientists for over a decade. After all, there are no active volcanoes on the surface of Mars, and no other explanation has been readily apparent to planetary scientists. However, as I first reported nearly a decade ago, investigators were surprised to find a correlation between the impact of a powerful CME at Mars and the appearance of the plumes. As David Andrews of the Swedish Institute of Space Physics noted, it's very surprising that was affecting Mars right before the plume was first observed. In fact, the dust-raising effects of electrical discharge has been a source of extensive experimental research within the electric universe community. And indeed, the obvious electrical nature of the event was suggested in a New Scientist report, which states, "One possibility is that plasma could be interacting with ice grains or dust lower down in the atmosphere and electrically charging them, boosting them higher, but it's not clear how the effect would be big." And here, I think we get some insight into a fundamental obstacle to progress in the space sciences. And that is, astronomers are trained to view planets and other celestial objects as electrically inert and isolated bodies. And yet, the bodies we observe in our solar system, including comets, asteroids, moons, and planets, occasionally produce spectacular phenomena which show all the characteristics of electrical discharge. This includes the collimated jets of comets, whose velocities and confinement over relatively large distances in the vacuum of space have never been explained by any mechanical model. It includes the so-called volcanic plumes seen exploding from the Jovian moon Io, whose filamentary features and other characteristics facially falsified the volcanism hypothesis. It includes the aforementioned dust explosions witnessed on Mars, an unsurprising correlation with the impact of a CME, and of course, it includes lightning on our own planet. the most visceral reminder for human beings of our innate connection to our electric universe.